Hello and welcome to one more episode of the Digital Transformation Show. Today from the offices of Rightly IP, and we are going to check out the office, see who is working today and what we can get out of them about this company. But what really makes a digital transformation company be complete, besides the team culture and their concept, is to actually have great customer support. And that is something that we have found in all of the companies that we have interviewed so far. So that is why today we are also going to interview the head of customer support at Rightly IP. Hello.
Hello.
Crashing into your desk. How are you?
I'm fine.
What's your name?
Uwe. I take care of all our customers, contact with our clients in the UK, in Denmark, in our clients in Germany. So it's a lot of international, always different and always really interesting to work with all the cultures of around the globe. And just seeing how the world of IP is not ready for what we come with, that is really funny. Like, we're trying to be innovative and coming out with new ideas and really helping people. It's really, really great to see. We're working with their trademark portfolios. So if they don't renew a trademark, that might mean a lot of business is lost. So we have to make sure that they feel secure every step of the way.
What do you think has enabled in this world to have this opportunity to work with so many countries at the same time?
All people are ready for online meetings. Before, it was harder to get people into the right meeting rooms, but right now everybody is so attuned with Zoom or Teams or what each meeting system you use. So instead of flying to Germany or flying to Norway, which we have done, we can have the meetings and we can even grow faster and grow better.
Thomas, I know that by now you know a lot about what is going on in the tech that you're using, but I would like to learn more about how did you manage to be part of this company in the first place and how did you learn all of this stuff?
Bjorn, who is the CEO, he was my former O-line coach at the Aarhus Tigers. Mm-hmm. I just started studying at the university, multimedia design and communications. And then Bjorn texted me one day on Facebook that he and his friend started up a new company and they needed some help with the web scraping. Mm-hmm. And then he asked me, do you know how to web scrape? And I didn't at that time, but of course I never say no to a challenge. So I told him yes. And then the rest is history. I've been here for 3 years now. So.
Okay. And you were the first employee after the founders?
Yeah.
That's right. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
So how does this actually work? You go online, you run your AI tech, you find the images of the counterfeits and identify them as fakes. And what happens later? What is the process with these big platforms?
There's a lot of data involved for our own platform. So we use all the data so the clients can actually log into our platform and get an overview. Mm-hmm. Of how many infringements have we removed from either Amazon, Alibaba, and so forth and so on. Mm-hmm. So the process is a huge process of not just finding the product, but then getting the data down so we can upload it directly into our system.
So finally, after a quick run around the office of Rightly IP, we're going to hear more about the history of Rightly IP.
Bjorn and I are longtime friends. We met when we were in the early 20s. And I guess we all always knew that we were going to do something together. We actually started out looking for a small apartment that we would rent to students. And that was just before the financial crisis in 2008. And thank God we didn't. But we always knew that we were going to do something together. We started in one room on the second floor.
Yeah.
Had the ground floor, and now we have the first and the second. So
taking over the world ground by ground.
Yep. Yes.
Do you think that the fact that you live in Denmark, that you have this so digitalized ecosystem in which doing everything from our phones is so natural nowadays, has somehow contributed to the growth of your company and the creation of itself?
We have an environment in Denmark that supports startups for sure. I think that we are so blessed in Denmark, growing up where we are, secure environment, everything is nice, we have a low crime, all that is nice in Denmark. So maybe we can focus more on developing stuff. But what we really want to do is to gather lawyers from all over the world using the Rightly platform, building a society of lawyers, of brand owners, where we can combat these criminals together.
Why intellectual property is so important, all the damage to society that comes with counterfeits and with what I would like to call, probably not politically correctly, fake products that imitate other brands.
If you can imitate it cheapest way possible, that is the same product, and then sell it make a profit from that, is run by criminals, and then they don't really care how the profits are earned, so to speak.
I read in some of your data that there are, for example, cosmetics or chemical products that are being produced in a very cheap way and being sold using brand names. How do you think you are actually attacking these?
Getting to the root of the problem is key here, because if you can close down that, then you close down the rest of the chain, and then you in the end close down the production of it. But of course, we are not naive, because then what we have seen with, for instance, some of our furniture clients is, well, then they just switch to other furniture production, and then we're on a mission to help everyone.
We just want to spread the world to join the battle. The stronger, the more we are, the stronger we stand. The data that we gather, combining that with our legal registrations and our law data, so to speak, is that we actually provide information to our clients in order to develop their business, also to develop and maybe find new manufacturers, new solid manufacturers, new partners all over the world. And that is also interesting for us.
Consumers are getting more and more conscious about it, as well as conscious about, okay, what is this I'm actually eating? How is this product that I'm using actually produced? I think there is a shift in society, but it's some studies also show that there's five-way to go. The consumers still needs to be even more enlightened about that. Just because you're able to buy it here in EU, it's not certified. Getting the young kids, getting for a young age, educating them on this is not okay because of, and then explaining why.
If I have one wish for Christmas, I can live with that. It would be that the legislation will actually follow the society better, that we could enforce better, that we have tools available to combat counterfeit. And again, I think it's really important to stress that counterfeit put the money in the hands of criminals, but it endangers all of us. Our kids play with the toys that are not regulated. Some of us might get medicine that's not regulated. And it's a growing problem, because the criminals see this as a great opportunity. And I know it's getting better, but there's a long, long way to go. Yeah. And the legislation is too far behind. So we try and combat the counterfeit, but they have the advantage, because it's still too difficult to enforce cross-border, cross-continents, because the legislation is so very different from country to country.
Where there is the legal battle is right now. And I think that's very interesting, because then again, referring back to combating in China, that you go to the root of the problem, because if it's illegal to store it in your warehouses, you kill the online business of it. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you need to fight fire with fire in these, because it's so new. And as Jeppe mentions, the legislation is not always there. And we have both with the Alibaba Group and also with the Amazon some dialogue going on. What do you enjoy the most being here at Rightly?
I would say the daily business. We have built a business with friends. The first employee we had was a friend of yours, a team buddy. The second we have was also a team buddy of yours. And being able to convince friends of ours to trust us to build a business together. I think that's rather unique. You need to have something, I would say, for them to trust us, at least.